Hello everyone. This is a very quick video showing how to test classes with Pytest. Now, if you look up how to do this, you will commonly find Pytest classes, which is something different. It's one of those old problems where I mentioned it last week in my PDF to DocX video. I'll put the link here. Sometimes you want to search for something a particular way around, but search engines see those two words and they actually find you the opposite. What we're doing here is creating a class, just as you would normally, testing the class in PyTest. We're not creating a class in PyTest. So this is something you will find less frequently when you search, but it is something you will still want to and need to do. So what I've made here is a class called car, def dunder in it, self.doors equals 5. I've created a function or a method even called get underscore doors. It returns self.doors. So what we want to do is we want to test this function, but we want to test it using PyTest. So within our test function file, even we've got from name of the file, the file's called pytc1, this file here that contains the car class, and then we're going to import the class called car. So car matches that. So the class name appears here and the file name as usual appears here. The function get underscore doors with test underscore in front of it. That doesn't have to match that with a test underscore in front. There's another way of doing it. You can do get underscore doors underscore test. Also, if you're writing a test class in PyTest, then you need to prefix it with capital test, capital T, E-S-T. Okay, so let's run this. And as always, it's better to run Python-M PyTest. If you just run PyTest itself, you may get module not found, and then you have to start chasing dunder init files all over the place. So there we go. One test passed. The reason it's passed is because I'm asserting that the response or for doors is equal to 5. So I'm saying test car, so that's the instance of my car class. And then I'm saying doors is equal to the method get doors of the car class. And the reason why that returns 5 is because when the instance is, or the class is instantiated, it's instantiated with a number 5. So that belongs to the instance regardless. So that's why we've got assert doors equals 5. If I wanted to, I could probably... Let's do it then, shall we? Let's write one more function just to belt and braces. Wheels. I know most cars have got 4 wheels, but there used to be one called a Robin Reliant that only had 3. And if we go back up here, and then we can do new line self.wheels equals 4. Okay, so we'll write that. And what happened there? And we want to go across to this one. And also we want to write a new test function. So def test, and then the name of the function inside the class, which is get underscore wheels. And we're doing the same as what we did above, really. So again, you have to create your instance. So I don't have to call it as anything different, but we're going to anyway, just because we can. Wheels equals test car 2 dot get underscore wheels. And then we assert that wheels equals, we want it to equal 4. And then we go across here and we'll run PyTest again. And what's happened? Ah, yeah, you see the problem? I only did one equals. Write that out again. And we've got two passing tests. So yeah, despite the pain of watching me miss out an equals and basically replicate a second function and then create a second test, it's all good. So hopefully this has cleared up the difference between creating a test in PyTest and using PyTest to test a class. So on that note, I'll see you next time.